Jesus was forever doing things that surprised, astounded, or even shocked the apostles. Finding Jesus talking to a strange Samaritan woman at Jacob's well was certainly one of these sorts of events. The story of the woman at the well is told in the Bible in John 4:4-42. In paper 143, the authors of the Urantia book also tell us about this encounter. Jesus was thirsty, but there was no way of getting water from the well. When, therefore, a woman of Sychar came up with her water pitcher and prepared to draw from the well, Jesus said to her,
"Give me a drink."
Her name was Nalda, and she was a comely creature. She was much surprised to have a Jewish man thus speak to her at the well and ask for water, for it was not deemed proper in those days for a self-respecting man to speak to a woman in public, much less for a Jew to converse with a Samaritan. Therefore, Nalda asked Jesus, "How is it that you, being a Jew, ask for a drink of me, a Samaritan woman?" Jesus answered,
"I have indeed asked you for a drink, but if you could only understand, you would ask me for a draught of living water."
Then said Nalda, "But sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Whence, then, have you this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this well, and who drank thereof himself, and his sons, and his cattle also?" Jesus replied,
"Everyone who drinks of this water will thirst again, but whosoever drinks of the water of the living Spirit shall never thirst. And this living water shall become in him a well of refreshment, springing up even to eternal life."
Nalda then said, "Give me this water, that I thirst not, and neither come all the way hither to draw. Besides, anything which a Samaritan woman could receive from such a commendable Jew would be a pleasure." Nalda did not know how to take Jesus' willingness to talk with her. Being a woman of lax morals, she was minded openly to become flirtatious when Jesus, looking straight into her eyes with a commanding voice, said,
"Woman, go get your husband and bring him hither."
This command brought Nalda to her senses. She saw that she had misjudged the master's kindness. She perceived that she had misconstrued his manner of speech. She was frightened. She began to realize that she stood in the presence of an unusual person, and groping about in her mind for a suitable reply, in great confusion, she said, "But, sir, I cannot call my husband, for I have no husband." Then said Jesus,
"You have spoken the truth, for while you may have once had a husband, he with whom you are now living is not your husband. Better it would be if you would cease to trifle with my words and seek for the living water which I have this day offered you."
By this time, Nalda was sobered and her better self was awakened. She was not an immoral woman wholly by choice. She had been ruthlessly and unjustly cast aside by her husband, and in dire straits had consented to live with a certain Greek as his wife, but without marriage. Nalda now felt greatly ashamed that she had so unthinkingly spoken to Jesus, and she most penitently addressed the Master, saying, "My Lord, I repent of my manner of speaking to you, for I perceive that you are a holy man, or maybe a prophet." Pointing over to Mount Gerizim, she continued, "Our fathers worshipped on this mountain, and yet you would say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Which, then, is the right place to worship God?" Jesus perceived the attempt of the woman's soul to avoid direct and searching contact with its Maker, but he also saw that there was present in her soul a desire to know the better way of life. Therefore he dealt patiently with her, saying,
"Woman, let me say to you that the day is soon coming when neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem will you worship the Father. But you should believe me when I say that the hour will soon come, even now is, when all sincere worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For it is just such worshipers the Father seeks. God is spirit, and they who worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Your salvation comes not from knowing how others should worship or where, but by receiving into your own heart this living water, which I am offering you even now.
But Nalda would make one more effort to avoid the discussion of the embarrassing question of her personal life on earth and the status of her soul before God. Once more she resorted to questions of general religion, saying, "Yes, I know, sir, that John has preached about the coming of the converter, he who will be called the deliverer, and that when he shall come, he will declare to us all things." And Jesus, interrupting Nalda, said with startling assurance,
"I who speak to you am he."
This was the first direct, positive, and undisguised pronouncement of his divine nature and sonship which Jesus had made on earth. And it was made to a woman, a Samaritan woman, and a woman of questionable character in the eyes of men up to this moment, but a woman whom the divine eye beheld as having been sinned against more than as sinning of her own desire, and as now being a human soul who desired salvation, desired it sincerely and wholeheartedly, and that was enough. As Nalda was about to voice her real and personal longing for better things and a more noble way of living, just as she was ready to speak the real desire of her heart, the 12 apostles returned from Sychar, and coming upon this scene of Jesus's talking so intimately with this woman, this Samaritan woman, and alone, they were more than astonished. They quickly deposited their supplies and drew aside, no man daring to reprove him, while Jesus said to Nalda,
"Woman, go your way. God has forgiven you. Henceforth, you will live a new life. You have received the living water, and a new joy will spring up within your soul, and you shall become a daughter of the Most High."
And the woman, perceiving the disapproval of the apostles, left her water pot and fled to the city. As she entered the city, she proclaimed to everyone she met, "Go out to Jacob's well and go quickly, for there you will see a man who told me all I ever did. Can this be the converter?" Unquote. Did Nalda change her ways? Neither the Bible nor the Urantia book tells us, but it seems reasonable to assume that she did, since she was receptive to Jesus' ministry.